Hey everyone, it's Caroline. I'm so excited today. You see, my friend Josh just got a brand new drone. This thing is so cool. It can fly, it has a camera, and he can operate it from his smartphone. I really want to see this drone in action, but Josh is tired today and doesn't want to have to leave the house. He was going to fly it over to me. After all, isn't that the whole fun of having a drone? The problem is that the drone only has a range of 1,800 feet before it stops working, and we don't really know how far apart we live. He doesn't want to take a chance and try it without knowing, and I don't blame him. What if it runs out of range before my house and gets stuck up in a tree? No, we can't just guess about this. We need to figure out the distance somehow. I'm betting that our next Prealgebra unit will be able to help me. In this video, I want to talk to you about the specifics of my situation with Josh, try to brainstorm some solutions, and take a look at what topics you can expect to learn by the end of this unit. Here's the neighborhood that Josh and I live in. I live here, and Josh lives here. If Josh's drone were to take the sidewalk to get to me, it'd have to go 4 blocks west and 3 blocks south. Now, I know how far that is. Each block is 300 feet, so that's 1,200 feet west and 900 feet south. That's 2,100 feet total. I know what you're thinking. Caroline, you just said this drone could only go 1,800 feet. That's too far. But drones don't have to walk on sidewalks. They can fly over all the houses and trees in between. So maybe there's still a chance it can make it. I just have to figure out how far it is between my house and Josh's house if the drone goes in the most direct path between them. I know I have a ruler, but that's not going to be long enough to measure with. No, we need to think bigger. We could try a tape measure, but even most of those only extend to 25 feet. That's better than a ruler, but what will we do about all the houses and trees in between us? I don't think I'm going to be able to do this myself. Okay, let's look at this again. If I can't actually go out into my neighborhood and measure this distance, I'm going to have to use some math to help me. What sticks out to you about this picture? Did you notice that the sidewalk paths and the drone path make a triangle? Specifically, they make a right triangle, with a 90-degree angle being this turn at the corner. So, we know that we're working with a right triangle. We also know that there's something in pre-algebra that can help us figure out the distance the drone will have to fly. But we don't have all the knowledge that we need just yet. By the time you finish this unit on the Pythagorean Theorem, you're going to be able to help Josh and I figure out if his drone can make it to my house. How? During this unit, we're going to make sure that you have all of the background information that you need to be a Pythagorean Theorem professional. To make sure you are prepared, you're going to start by learning about the foundations of square roots and the foundations of right triangles. Then we can get to the final prize, the Pythagorean Theorem. At the end of the unit, we'll wrap it all up and come back to figure out if Josh's drone can make it to my house. To help you stay organized and build strong habits during this unit, we have a notes template available for you. You'll find these notes in the teaching section for this lesson. You'll want to download and print the document. Take good notes and keep them somewhere safe for future reference. You're definitely going to want these notes when this topic comes up again in high school geometry. I'll see you and your printed notes next time. Hey, hey.